I wanted to show you is a puzzle problem. It's a net matching problem. I was interested in that problem because the winner, the people who could solve it, could win $2 million. So that was quite interesting. It's a 16 by 16 edge matching puzzle. And the problem is that one. You need to place all the pieces here. Okay, it's all, a piece is something like this. So that if you have two pieces next to each other, they have exactly the same color, right? And so you can see that every one of them here, they have the same color. So you need to find how to place the pieces and find the correct rotation for each of them. And of course, here in that solution, sometimes you have a violation that are represented here by the black lines. Okay, you see that yellow is not equal here to the purple, and that's a problem, okay? Same here between green and blue. So we have some violations here. And the goal is to maximize the number of correct connections, the correct matching edges here. So how to solve that problem with local search? One neighborhood that you could imagine is just to take two pieces and swap them on the board, and you could possibly rotate them. If you do that, the best violation that you can reach, the correct number of connections is 480 on that problem. If you do that, you will quickly reach what we call a plateau here, and you will not be able to reach much more than 320. So how to escape from this local minima? The goal is always the same. We need to enlarge a little bit the neighborhood. And so maybe we could optimize a sub problem here that would could be easier, right? Move more than two pieces at once. Okay, the problem is that it's as difficult as the original problem, okay? Because you need to solve this some problem, this sub problem, but it might also be large. So we will prefer instead a generalization of the swap and rotate move, but we will remove n pieces from the board which are not adjacent positions, and we will replace them all together optimally. This seems quite magic, but it's possible in polynomial time to explore this neighborhood. The idea is the following. So you will remove the one that you used to have here. So you remove them, okay, because they are not matching. I put them there, okay? And I will replace them optimally to minimize the number of violations. For that, I create what I call a bipartite graph, okay? From the positions to the pieces that I have removed. And I will compute for every pair of position to a piece the optimal rotation and the cost that would be induced if I would place that piece to that position with that that rotation. And so you have a bipartite graph with weights on the edges. Okay. You pre-compute it like this. And then you can solve what we call a maximum assignment problem. There is a well-known algorithm for solving that problem. It's a graph problem. And then once you have that, you find the optimal matching problem, the maximum assignment problem. Then you can replace the edges that are selected by the algorithm will give you the optimal replacement of the pieces inside the holes of the board, inside the holes of the pieces that you have removed from the board. So you will explore really a very large neighborhood that is exponential in size, but you will explore it optimally in polynomial time. And so that's always a good idea to look for neighborhoods with such property that are very large, but you can explore them in polynomial time. If you do that, you will discover that you can reach much better solutions because, for instance, here you can really remove and place all together 64 pieces of the board. So that's much better. So you will be less blind, and as a consequence, you will be able to reach better solutions. So what I expect from you at the exam is be able to explain the principle behind local search, be able to implement a simple search with swap moves, taboo search, understand the constraint-based local search framework that we have with MiniLS, be able to suggest a neighborhood for a new problem, explain the problem that we have seen, the TSP, Lynn-Kernighan, and the vehicle routing problems, how to apply it for scheduling problems, and finally, the very large neighborhood search that we just have seen for eternity problems.